Hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. As many of you already know, the company film from Aarhus has been following me around for many years now, being courtside at one of the some of the biggest tournaments in the world, and been filming close hand. So we have a lot of exciting footage, and we wanted to do something special. So a good idea we came up with was to look at some of the slow motion footage we have from, you know, 2014, 2017, from one of the, from some of the exciting matches and tournaments in my career. And the first one we're going to do today is from the 2014 World Championships in Denmark. This was a big tournament for me. I grabbed my first World Championship medal, a bronze medal. So I'm going to look at the slow motion footage here and going to do my comments and sort of talk about what the difference is compared to then until now, and what I can see from the footage when it comes to my movements and my way of playing, etc. So I really hope you enjoy it, and let's get to it. So obviously, you know, playing a world championship on home soil is always a special thing, and I was a little bit tense and nervous going into it because I knew that I had a shot on a medal if I played really well, but obviously I didn't really know what to expect. As you can see here, a young Axelsen is going on court, playing with the Yonix Arc Shaper 11, which was a great racket for sure. I was playing Henry Huskind in the first round, who I played a few times before in some of the international tournaments, and here I'm up against him in the first round. A really skillful player, but I knew that if I played my aggressive playing style, I would have a good chance. As you can see here, my physique and technique is a little bit different compared to now, and I wasn't that patient on court compared to now for sure. Also, I was trying to, obviously playing in a high pace and wanted to get a good start on the tournament since I was at home, and you want to get this good feeling. As you can see here, for the next shot, I'm taking the shuttle a little bit too late on the net compared to what I want to do now. I want to reach it as high as possible many times to put pressure on the opponent, but obviously sometimes it's good to make a deception also. Kenneth and Lasua was behind the court. Lasua was the head coach, but Kenneth was still responsible for me back then. So we really tried to focus on, playing the next rally with the right mindset, and don't think too much about, oh, we're in Denmark, my family are watching, etc. So definitely playing on home soil, the mental part of the game is a really, really big part of it. I was playing with the Yonix Arc Shaper 11 back then, which was a really, really nice racket, and actually the first racket I started using after getting Yonix as a sponsor again. As you can see here, my physique is a little bit more, not fragile, but I'm a smaller person back then compared to now, and there has happened a lot since I started working with Sean Casey it back in 2015. Back then I still wasn't working with Sean, and he made a big difference on my career. Also, as you can see here on my back, my rear court action here, my elbow is a little bit lower back then compared to now. So now I'm really trying to get my elbow up a little bit higher so I can get the ankles on the shots. Also, my initial thoughts here is my grip is a little bit different. I'm holding the racket a little bit more inside my hand, like this, but now I'm trying to have a little bit of a looser grip. I was definitely also crossing more on the net back then, as you just saw, and just a different player compared to now. And as you can see here, I'm trying to celebrate the good rallies with a pumped fist here. I won the first round against Henry Huskind after being a little bit tense. And I remember after the match, I was actually really, really stiff in my right leg because I was quite tense going, in front to the lunges, etc. So I definitely felt really tired and stiff in my leg, in my right leg, actually the whole tournament, because I came so, tense into the first round. But obviously I was really happy to go on to the next round and win the first one, because when you win the first rounds are always tough, you know, you have to get used to the surroundings and you want to start off well, etc. So I was definitely happy with it. And actually during this tournament we stayed at the hotel even though I was really close to home, because you still want to be in this tournament mode where you're used to staying at hotels. So it was a proper setup, and just as we normally do when we're out traveling around the world. The only difference was that your friends and family was in the stands, but I was still trying to focus mainly on playing the games and not so much on the daily stuff back in Denmark. As you can see here, I don't know what I'm looking at here, but I'm probably looking at the shuttles and using the grip powder, the Yonix grip powder with a red Yonix towel grip, as I'm still doing now. Grip powder is a big part of my badminton career still, because I do sweat a lot of my hands. So as you can see here, since then I've used the wristband and the grip powder on my towel grip. Here up against Thi Minh Nguyen from Vietnam, a really quick player, and what is important here is to really play aggressively also. Here, as you can see, we're working on the right leg and also stretching out my back here with Michael Rees, who is the main physio and the guy I'm working mostly with back in Denmark. We also have my former mental coach Carsten Ollengaard in the corner there. As you know, and I just touch on, I'd really try to focus a lot on the mental side of things. Here, going on court again, I remember it was really, really hot in the arena, and there wasn't much air condition. So it was really important for me to drink a lot during the tournament, because we sweat a lot compared to what we usually do when we're playing in Denmark. Flash forward to the semifinal here, up against Li Chunwei, and I'm just gonna put it out there. He was way better than me and quicker than me, and I had no chance. But obviously, winning against Chou Jin-chen as I did in the quarterfinal and securing myself a bronze medal was a big, big win for me. But I remember feeling on court against Li Chunwei that he was just simply so, so strong, and I had no chance whatsoever. He was quick, he was explosive, he was mixing up his attacks. And when I got off court after the semifinal there, I just remember thinking that he's gonna win this thing. Obviously, he ended up losing to Chen Long in the final, but still, I remember feeling that, whoa, he was really, really quick and fast. As you can see here, I remember playing a little bit too passively in that match, but I simply wasn't able to play an aggressive playing style against Li Chunwei, because he was making it hard for me. And every time I tried to attack, he was twisting and turning me, making it really hard for me to make points. It was a tough match for me, and I think I got like 8 or 6 or something against him. But that was it. I was just up against a better player, and as you can see here, it's still taking the shots a little bit too late on the front court, in my opinion. And as you can see here, I'm receiving my medal from Paul Erik Højer together with Tommy Sugiyato, Chen Long the winner, and Li Chunwei the runner-up. Even though I lost the semifinal really big, I was so, so happy with this tournament. It was my first World Championship medal on home soil also, and it was a big, big moment for me. And yeah, I just remember I was out celebrating with my friends afterwards also, so everything was just like I'd hoped it would be. So yeah, that was it, guys. It has been so fun to commentating on this slow motion footage from many years ago now. Time really flies, and it has been really fun to see the difference back then compared to now. We're gonna do another slow motion video here on YouTube really soon, and next time from All England. So it's gonna be really, really fun to do that one also. But I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did so, remember to subscribe and share the video if you want to, and also leave a comment down below. I really enjoy reading your comments, and if you think this was useful, we would love to know. So thank you so much, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Take care, and have a good one.